Hi, Sung.
Good to see you again, Liz. Thanks for having me on.
So during this time of incredible economic disruption, technology is one of the few sectors that's seen positive net inflows year to date. What's your take on the resiliency of the tech sector?
So the tech sector, as you know, has really led the bull market over the last 10 years. And so I think a lot of people are surprised to see that the tech sector has also been the best performing sector during the most recent crisis. And very simplistically, the reason why tech is outperforming the other sectors is because their fundamentals are better. So earnings and revenues have fared better throughout the crisis than their other sectors. If you look at the overall S&P 500, earnings estimates have come down by roughly 20% overall, excluding the tech sector, but the tech sector is only down 7%. And if you exclude some of the cyclical areas of tech, it's actually down less than that. And so fundamentals, as consumers have had to spend more of their lives at home, and as corporations have had to adapt to much more agile working environments, fundamentals for the tech sector have just really held it a lot better.
So outside of the forces created by the pandemic, what else is it about technology companies that's allowed them to outperform?
So irrespective of the cycle and what's happening in the current COVID environment, there are a couple of characteristics of tech companies that make them inherently much more defensive than other sectors as well. The first are their balance sheets. The balance sheets just have net cash in their balance sheets, so there's no debt relative to the market where you find a lot of leverage. Secondly, over the last 5 years, tech companies have really aggressively transitioned towards recurring business models, which also give them a lot more visibility, which is what investors are looking for.
So traditionally, large mega cap stocks have been the place where technology investors have gone. Is that still the best place to be?
That's a great question, Liz. For the past two decades, the innovation around technology is largely centered in the US and is largely centered around the big mega caps. And that's why investors have seen the most returns in those stocks and where investors are currently the most overweight as well. But what's exciting now is that the innovation is now expanding beyond the mega caps into the emerging markets. And also we're finding a lot more opportunities down the market cap spectrum in the US. And this is happening for two primary reasons. The first is emerging markets consumers are getting access to fast, ubiquitous internet for the first time in their history. As LTE has persisted across these different regions, and as consumers have now access to a smartphone, most people can access fast internet at the tip of their fingers. And that's giving rise to local e-commerce giants who are trying to become the next Amazon, the next PayPal, and the next Netflix of the regions. In the US, down the market cap spectrum, the public cloud is actually giving rise to a host of new SaaS software companies who are disrupting old technologies and old corporate behavior with software that's allowing its employees to be much more productive and deliver it at a significantly lower cost.
So as an investor, when you look across the tech sector broadly, how are you thinking about companies that have been affected both positively and negatively by the pandemic?
So our research team right now is focused on putting tech investments right now into three very large buckets. The first bucket are companies that are currently benefiting from the crisis, but we think that benefit is unlikely to be sustainable. So think video conferencing, certain parts of e-commerce, and things like PCs where the demand has escalated, but we think that's going to be unsustainable over the long term. The second major bucket are those companies that are benefiting from the crisis, but are likely to see a sustainable advantage coming out of that crisis, out of the crisis as well. So think SaaS software companies as companies shift more towards agile working environments. And think payments companies who are right now seeing cyclically depressed fundamentals, but underneath the hood, they're acquiring subscribers at 2.5x the rate that would have historically. And so you're seeing an acceleration in payments activity that's unlikely to go backwards. The third bucket of investing that we're looking at right now are cyclically depressed areas of the market. So companies that are selling into small and medium-sized businesses, for example, or semiconductor companies that are selling into cyclically depressed areas like autos. We fully expect as the environment normalizes that these companies will have a strong rebound. So we're primarily focused on those last two buckets.
So before the economic shutdown, we saw increased interest in the technology companies, particularly the social media companies, from regulators and policymakers. Is that still a significant risk?
In the US, it's unclear what form regulation will ultimately take. However, the rhetoric will undoubtedly pick up as we get closer to elections. In Europe, we've seen a specific set of new regulations put forth aimed at curbing monopolistic behavior, as well as raising taxes. And if these regulations are enacted, it could be a headwind to earnings for a lot of the mega cap tech companies. But I do want to talk a little bit about another risk to the tech sector currently, which is the US-China trade relations. So I think it's fairly well understood that tariffs and trade wars will lead to higher prices for consumers and will lead to certainly lower top line for a lot of tech companies. But what's less understood is what's going on around margins. As we speak to corporate CEOs, it appears the priority around supply chains is shifting from one that optimizes around cost alone to one that optimizes around supply and availability. And so as companies increasingly diversify their supply chains, it can undoubtedly lead to lower margins in the future.
So finally, Sung, you talked about the strong fundamentals of technology companies, but we've also seen some extreme valuations. How should investors be thinking about that?
That's a great question. Yeah, and one that I get all the time. You know, there are certainly pockets of the tech universe that are at extreme valuations, especially the ones that I described before, where we think that the fundamentals are going to be unlikely to be sustained. But on the flip side, there are areas of the market with depressed fundamentals and attractive valuations that remain a buying opportunity. And we're really focusing on those areas, the technology market. But if you wanted some broader perspective of where tech valuations currently sit, tech in the S&P 500 is currently trading at a 10% premium to the rest of the market. This compares to a 20% premium over the last 20 years. So we could debate whether we think that the market overall is expensive, but we believe that tech relative to the market continues to be very attractive.
Thanks, Sung.
Thank you, Liz, for having me.